C++ function arguments. If a function is to use arguments, it must declare variables that accept the values of the arguments. These variables are called the formal parameters of the function. In the previous program also, we have shown you that to pass two arguments to the max function, I had to define two variables, and those two variables were passed as input arguments to the max function. And when we define the max function, then we had two parameters to receive those two argument values. So those parameters which will be defined with the function definition will be treated as a local variable. And when the function will have an entry, that means when the function will get the control of execution, then the memory spaces are getting allocated for those parameter variables. And when the function will get terminated, when the control is coming out from the function, then those variables allocated spaces are getting released and variables are getting deleted from the memory. So the formal parameters behave like other local variables inside the function and are created upon entry into the function and destroyed upon exit. While calling a function, there are three ways to pass these arguments. So these ways are call by value, call by pointer, and call by reference. So this method copies the actual value of an argument into the formal parameter of the function. In this case, changes made to the parameter inside the function have got no effect on the argument. I'm passing one argument. The argument was having some initial value. The value of the argument has been received in one of the parameters. The parameter value has got changed locally within the function. After coming back, I can find that the argument values, they have got not changed. So we are having the next one, that is a call by pointer. So here, this method copies the address of an argument into the formal parameter. Inside the function, the address is used to access the actual argument used in the call. This means that changes made to the parameter affect the argument. Here we are passing not the parameter, not the argument, but the address of the argument. So as a result of that, the parameter will receive the address of the argument. So whatever the changes they are making at those addresses within the function body, those updates can be reflected, can be accessed, can be observed from the caller function when the control will come back. Next one is your call by reference. This method copies the reference of an argument into the formal parameter. Inside the function, the reference is used to access the actual argument used in the call. This means that changes made to the parameter affect the argument also. So in case of call by reference, the reference of the argument will be passed to the parameters. So what about the changes we are doing within the function body in the parameters? So the updates can also be observed from the caller function in the argument variables. So these are the three methods with the help of which we can pass our arguments to a function. So we are having separate videos on each one of them. Please watch them for the better understanding. Thanks for watching this video.